I like to do the workshop as if you were the learners. Whenever I start a session, I will always put on the board what I expect each learner to do. So if you can look to see what number you are, and then the table at the front is that one, and then you can do what's So, like we used in the PE session, whenever you want to get your class back again, we use the silent signal. This is the one that I've chosen to use. What it means is you're not using your voice too much, and the learners come very used to it, so they can just tap each other on the shoulder, they see it, and then you've immediately got everyone back. What we've just done there, you've used your manage mats, and what you've done is you've set up your lesson in less than 20 seconds. So I'm just showing you a tip of how you can use your manage mats straight away at the beginning of the lesson. And then at the end of the lesson, you can also, I would just write it up, you do that again, and you get all the resources put back, you get their tables put back. It's giving your learners responsibility, and that is cooperative learning. That's the first thing, so you've done that in like 10 seconds. So just to tell you a bit where we're going, we've only got 20 minutes. So in this school improvement plan, under mindsets, we have developed the use of cooperative learning strategies and other explicit strategies. So what we're doing as a school now is we're developing this. So you as teachers will now be using the cooperative learning strategies in your classes, and that's what we're doing with the school improvement plan. Okay, so with these breakfast bites, the intention is that you feel confident to use these structures, and then the learners will feel confident, and then throughout the school they'll be able to use them. Having reflected on the workshop and reflected on the stage last year of experimenting, we decided it's really best to start with the foundations. So the structure that we're going to start with today, we did do in the workshop, and some of you have experimented in before, but what we believe is that you just need to feel confident, and we're going to start from basics and work our way up. And then the learners too will be able to use the language, okay? So we're going to be starting today with Rally Robin. And I'm not going to play this yet, but what I will do with you is share each week, but you can't, this presentation. And for each structure, I've videoed the structure. So if you want to have fun looking at me doing the structure with the class, you can, but we won't do that now. I'll be getting to this later, but there's a place for you as well. When you use this structure over the next 2 weeks, can you please put the photographs and videos of you using the structure in the folder? Then we'll have a bank of resources for the rest of the school, okay? So the objectives for today is to know when to use Rally Robin. We're gonna discuss the tips for the successful implementation. We're gonna be confident, so you'll have some time practicing. We'll look at some class management skills. I don't think we're gonna have time for the class builder and the team builder, but I've put them onto the slideshow. So if we do have time, but we'll have a quick time for that at the end. This is just an overview. Again, you can look at this in your own time of what we'll be doing until Christmas. So what's expected of you? So like I said, what we would like is you're going to do one structure today, and we're going to look at all the areas I just looked at. Then go back to your year group or department and feed back that structure. Excuse me, you all have, if number, one of the people on your table should have brought you one of these each. So you've now got a copy of the structure. So when you've got your Marcos meeting or department meeting, could you go back and feed back this structure? And then also experiment with your classes, and then put any videos, photos, like I said, or even anecdotal evidence. This worked or this didn't work. Then we've got a bank of resources and evidence for the whole school. When we go back to structures, what I really, really want to stress, and it was stressed in the PD session, the first time you ever do it with learners, do it for fun. Now, by fun, what we mean is you are concentrating on the structure and not the academic content. So if I was to use the structure times pair share, I might do talk about your favorite food. And the next time I use it, I might apply it to go with the flow, our unit, and I would apply it to what do you already know about rivers. So it's not the first time you ever expose your learners to it. It's not every time you use it. Otherwise that would become quite tedious. Okay, so that's when, in the training she was speaking about that. It's just so they can concentrate on the steps and not the academic content. Refer to the structure by its name, and we all get confused, and we have been across the year group, and that's why if you've got this, you can refer to it. The reason we say refer to it by its name is because then the learners will get used to it, and then you can just say, everybody, Rally Robin, and they'll do it, and it reduces teacher talk time. Try to follow the steps as much as possible, but the first time you do it, if you go wrong, it doesn't matter. You know, just as much as possible, keep it the same, just for the learners, so that they can do it on their own. And just get learners to really know the structure before you introduce too many. Again, we wanted to say, it's fine that some of you are introducing lots of different structures, go with it. But we are explicitly focusing on Rally Robin for these 2 weeks. Okay, that's the evidence we want to collect, and the photos and videos, okay? And one of the big things, so why are we doing these structures? And I find myself always looking now. It's because when, even with lolly sticks or whatever, when you open that question to the class, before you do that, every learner's got a chance to share, and every learner is actually participating. So if you remember, they were saying equal participation. And it's true. Every single person in the room has got a chance to share before you then pull that lolly stick out and say, John, he's had a chance, okay? So you can combine it with lolly sticks. So that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to, if you were to walk into a classroom, every learner is engaged and every learner is participating. That's what these structures do in a nutshell. Rally Robin. So again, most people in this class have already been exposed to Rally Robin. Whenever in Kagan there's the word rally, it means between two people. And Robin means it's a speaking one. So you can just remember, whenever you see rally, two people, Robin, speaking. And there's a lot of me speaking now, but so when would we use this structure? It's amazing for pre-assessment to find out what the learners already know at the beginning of new learning. Again, you're starting something new, bam, give them a chance to share. With a new class, so that you can get them interacting with the person sat next to them. Like I said before, lolly sticks, unexpected visitor, it's great for this. We know what it's like. Someone comes through your door and they have to speak to you about the aircon. You can say, okay, everybody, Rally Robin, favorite food. You've got 1 minute to talk to facilities. It's fantastic. Okay. And we use them for a class or a team builder. Then we'll talk more about that another week, but that's when you want to do something to bond the children. So you do it for fun. When they need a brain break, so you've been doing your learning, you just need to give them a break. Okay, let's do a Rally Robin. And before the end of the lesson, to consolidate what they've learned.
Julian, can I just ask the brain break?
Yes,
you know, she's talking about 10 minutes,
yeah.
And then break 10 minutes, and then just mm-hmm. get the glucose going. Mm-hmm. Are we talking about it like that, or is it by sight and feeling?
No, so you can give a brain break every 10 minutes, Or if they're on a task, like a writing task for language arts, and they're completely engaged, just for the sake of it, don't. But if you feel, hang on a minute, it's time for a brain break, get them to do it. And you can, we'll look at the structure again in a moment, but get them standing up as well to do it. But it's just to have a break from it. So be clear with the learners, with Rally Robin, that it's a list. So for those of you who are not familiar with Rally Robin, we're using two people, and in the setup that you're in, with the grouping that you're in at the moment, you can work with your shoulder partner or you can work with your face partner. When you're doing a Rally Robin, it's going from one person to the next person like this. So it's a list. So it could be colours, then it would just go red, cycle, any colour? So it's really important that you specify it's a list, because otherwise they go off talking in sentences and things, it won't be a Rally Robin. So it's just in, like in sport, it's going between the two. We're going to go through structure step by step. When you give the think time, you raise the question. Think time, I think, is best with your hand, and you do it in silence. And you can just do that. And that's just the amount of time they need to think before doing anything. So you've got your quiet signal, which flows into your think time. So you've got them focused and then thinking. From experience, I find this really, really works. Make sure you specify who goes first, and that's very simple if you have a manage map, because in front of you it says B or A, so you can just say A goes first or B goes first. Really important, let the learners know how long it will last, and I highly recommend using a timer, but let them know, because otherwise they're going to be sat there going, and then they might start talking about other stuff just to fill the timer. So are they working with their shoulder or their face? Make sure they don't start till you say go. I say go, but you can have a different word, because otherwise you've got this table starting, this table. So it's really important they all start at the same time. For early years, Andrea, I would highly recommend using a ping pong ball or some kind of, what those things called, beanbag things. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Because then they're physically passing it back and forth when they're doing the structure, or even in years one and two, and I use them sometimes in year six. So looking at the time, it's best that we're just going to give you some practice time. So as the teacher, you would announce the structure. So I'm just going to do it with this table here, and then I'm going to give you some time to practice. So now we're going to do Rally Robin. State the question. The question is, can you think of lots of different kinds of food? You are going to Rally Robin for 30 seconds. B is going to start. Put your hands on your head if you're B. I'm going to give you think time. Go.
Roast chicken, apple pie, apple crumble, cherry, cranberry cheesecake, veggie, roti canai, rendang, curry, chicken curry, biryani, mutton, chocolate. Sorry.
Thank you. Because you've been sharing your learning, when I say go, I'd like you to say thank you for sharing to your shoulder partner.
Thank you for sharing.
What's really interesting, and this is why these sessions are really important, we want to do the troubleshooting. In my instruction, I wasn't clear that one person needed to say a food, then the next, then the next. So this is absolutely great, because now as teachers we can see that we need to be very clear in the instruction. So actually, B says a food, then A, then B, then A, then B, then A. So that was great. So if that happens in your class, you can just stop, you can do it again. It's not a problem. And that's why we want to have these sessions, so that you all feel confident. What we're going to do now, in your teams, so there's three on that table, that's wonderful, there's four. Two of you can be the learners, and one of you can be the teacher. And you can just go through the structures as if you were doing the rally robin. It'd be great if you could actually stand up as the teacher. So you've got the two people doing the rally robin, you've got the teacher, and the other person can just listen to the teacher and see if there's anything they forget or if there's something they could do to improve it. Is everybody clear? Okay? When it comes to timing, you can just roughly time it for 30 seconds and then you can swap over so you've got a different teacher, a different observer, and two different students. Okay, off you go.
You're going to name as many animals as you can in 30 seconds. A, you are going to go first. Take your time. And that's your 30 seconds. Well done. Please congratulate each other.
To get them to interact 30 seconds, but maybe you want them to really think about what they already know about animals, go for longer. And again, it's experimentation. That's why we're doing this slowly, so that you can experiment yourself.
So would that be longer in time or longer rather than one word phrase?
Oh no, time.
Okay. When, still one word phrase.
Yeah. Next time, so not next week, the week after, we'll go to timed pair share, which is where you give lengthier answers. This is when you just want a list. And the gambits, which are on the workshop on the PD, you can just use thank you for sharing. Or if you want to be slightly more American, you can introduce the things that we did like great. It's up to you. The importance is social skills. So that's why we're grouping with shoulder partners is the social skills. So that they learn to thank each other for sharing and look each other in the eye. And you might have seen the thing on the door, but that's a huge thing with cooperative learning, is to encourage the learners to say positive things to each other. So even when they're sat down next to someone, it's sorry, but you're here, so it's quite easy for them to make silly noises like, oh no, or, and you need, no, you need to say thank you for sharing, you need to smile, you need to give eye contact, so you're doing loads of social skills as well. Very, very quickly, we've got 1 minute left. Just a few things I wanted to add, which I've touched on, and I wanted to touch on a few things each week. Quiet signal, really important, which we touched on. A timer. Again, Melanie was saying that the younger children don't have a concept of time. Actually, when you have a big timer, they learn to look at it, and it means that a writing activity of 10 minutes, they can start to regulate themselves. And then when they're doing a rally robin, they know how long they've got to go on for. So I highly recommend a visual timer, not just a timer for you, but for the learners. You might have noticed I've got day-to-day resources on the tables. That's if you are grouping for purpose this way. It just means that all the learners have got everything they need, like four whiteboards, four pens, and they take responsibility for what they need for cooperative learning. And you saw that the learners actually can go and collect anything else. In fours just means that you've got shoulder partner and face. I've got manage mats, which makes it easy for who's going to start. It just reduces teacher time. This person's going to start, bam, bam, bam. Again, I put at the beginning who's doing what. As you'll see throughout the breakfast bites, I use a lot of music cues as well, so that actually I won't even say the name of a certain structure. The music comes on and they'll get up and do it. Really reduces time from you and gives them time to cooperate. And C3 before me, you might have seen it up here. It means that when learners don't know what to do or they start a task, they first speak to their shoulder partner, then their face partner, then the diagonal partner, and then they ask you. And it really means that the other members of the team, when they're grouped like this, take responsibility to listen and share what to do before they automatically say your name as a teacher. We don't have time to do class builders and team builders, but I will send details out to you via email. I have all your email addresses, so what I'll do is I'll send this presentation to you within the next couple of days. And our next session is on time to pair share. Very lastly, if you have any questions, please email me. And secondly, please have fun with the structure and put your photos, videos, and evidence in the folder. There's a link on the presentation.
Can we put our sequence in?
Your what?
Sequence, like our scoping sequence document.
Everything, whack it in. Yeah, it's all in there.
So I can put that into the evidence as well.
Yeah, just give me a day to make sure that you've all got access and everything to it. Okay, but any questions, please email me.
Thank you, Janine.